A long-awaited report by the Independent Commission Against Corruption has been handed down, finding former New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian and former Wagga Wagga MP Daryl Maguire engaged in serious corrupt conduct. To unpack what this means, let's go to state political reporter Lachlan Kennedy. Lachie, it's a very thick report, but what are the key points?
Yeah, 700 pages across two volumes, Narelda, with some pretty bombshell findings. The most serious, that Gladys Berejiklian and Daryl Maguire engaged in serious corrupt conduct in their time. Now, as a way of background for those not familiar with this case, the Independent Commission Against Corruption here in New South Wales, ICAC, established Operation Keppel to look into Daryl Maguire and accusations he was using his office as an MP for profit, working with developers and a visa immigration scheme. It launched in September 2020. A few months later, it was exposed that he had been in a secret relationship with then Premier Gladys Berejiklian. She resigned from the top job in October 2021 when ICAC officially announced it was looking into her. Essentially today, what it has found is that Gladys Berejiklian breached the Ministerial Code of Conduct and engaged in corrupt conduct by keeping that relationship a secret from all her colleagues as they decided to grant tens of millions of dollars to projects in Daryl Maguire's electorate. ICAC also finding that she breached her duties by not basically revealing and referring to the corruption body allegations and suggestions that Daryl Maguire was engaging in those corrupt behaviours, working with property developers and the visa immigration scheme. The report was handed down today. Here was the initial reaction of the new New South Wales Premier, Labor's Chris Minns.
Firstly, this report's taken way too long. I think that's been generally recognised across the political spectrum in New South Wales. The second point here is that nothing in this report takes away, I don't think, from Premier Berejiklian's handling of the COVID emergency, which I still regard as being excellent. It's important, however, for all politicians in New South Wales and anyone in public life or positions of leadership to understand that we must manage conflicts of interest and, in particular, declare them.